I'm not coming to this wall. I wanna be helpful too, so, yeah, if there's something that I can help with, then I wanna do that.
It's somewhere in that hot mess.
And my other one? Yeah, he's nine. Yeah. He's nine. He is. If you could just have Miss Bishop the whole time, that would be great. Just great, she's great.
I agree with you. So Chad is, well, my twin's Chad, that's fine, so Chad's in this kitchen.
Everything else.
Yeah, well, he's in third grade right now, so, but he had, I think he had her last year for second grade, because they did that kind of weird, so I'm down.
That was our December workshop.
Unless you do something really weird, so then, no, we won't.
It's staying the way it is right now, because that was our best.
So, yeah, she's really good, right, Chad?
Oh.
So I'm just like, that's she.
Well, because I was still working on it.
Can we table it then?
Actually, I'd like to take a look at it.
What is that?
It's the numbers we worked out from the December workshop.
Are we opening, am I opening?
Yeah.
Opening meeting 7:03. I don't remember. I know, I don't remember what I said last time.
All right, so that's all 2017. Okay, so I take it we can start with tuition. Want to just get that out of the way?
Yeah, we have to figure out Raleigh tuition tonight so I can upload it.
Yes.
To our new software.
Okay. And that's a bunch of recommended numbers from our meeting.
So this was 2018. So 290, would that be, is that early bird or is that? Was the 290 early bird, do you know?
Whatever we decide on the number is early bird, and then we add more for later, is how that has all worked.
All right, so if we.
But I.
Is it 290?
I thought that looks low to me, so.
So two, okay.
Anybody else have memories of that day, because that seems low to me.
We did, that was the 290, that was the number.
We didn't at all?
That was the number in December that Dee wanted us to go with, it was 290. But we ended up not, he suggested not going over 290 in an email.
That would be.
Never checked my document.
My 290 would have been for non-early bird though.
So.
What we did with early bird stuff, let's just re back to last year. Our early bird rate was the rate that we came up with. What we did, so we actually never went lower than that number. What we did was add 25 bucks later.
Yeah.
So our bottom line was the 240 mm-hmm. last year. So then that became our early bird rate.
Is
and then our,
yeah, then we added
25. right.
Yeah,
right. Is that, I just want to make sure everybody's on the same page on that
or
one.
Show that somehow.
Oh, do you need this?
Well, I was just,
I can make copies.
Yeah, if you could just make just
copies.
A couple pages with the, not the first page.
There's a couple of numbers on it.
Okay.
It's just easier.
So, here's the thing, so I don't even know where to begin. I mean, I ran so many numbers from last year. And so I think what we really need to do is if we just resign ourselves to the fact that the town's going to have to kick in, regardless of what we do. I mean, in order for us to cover just salaries based on.
How are you going to survive when you turn that over to the library?
We were just
I'm going to have to go over there. It's a numbers game, right?
to the increased salaries while it's working.
So what's $300 a month? Well, $300 for the summer divided by 8 weeks.
It's less than 40.
It's 37.50.
We said at our November summer workshop that we did $45 a week, which brought us out to 360, and that includes busing and t-shirts. So that's, or $40 a week down to, and then your $40 registration fee would be $400 even. But that's all your busing fees, so you're not paying $5 a week. That was,
is that an all-inclusive bill?
Yes. Yes. All-inclusive t-shirts, registration, and bus for $400.
And then the second child is $320.
I have it where, so I did that again today with numbers, so we did $5 less per second child, so it would work out. This number to me seems high, but so I don't, we have the workshop numbers that we're good, but. So if it's $320 per week with the, at the $40 a week for the first kid, and then it would be $280 for the second kid, so that, that comes to $600, but with we would add $80 for the bus fee for two kids, so that's $680, and then one registration fee would be $720 for two kids.
Mm-hmm. So what we did in December was $360, and then $680 for two kids with your $40 registration would be $720. Is that what you just said, Kelly?
Yes, but that, and that included bus money for both kids.
Okay, so yeah. I put a note on the side of the minutes.
Yeah.
Because we made a point that families of three or more, their bus fees would be included. So I wasn't clear based on that, so I put a bubble on the side. Does this include t-shirts and bus fees for all families or for families of three or more only?
So if I can back up, there's other buckets to think about while we're thinking about tuition too, right? So we think about if we only charge a little bit more money for the families each summer, there's other ways we can try to make up for it. So for example, pre and post care, we can promise to keep it the same. Actually, pre and post care kind of worked for us. There are things that work for us, right? Like the structure of the program. The pre and post care works, so I don't see changing that unless we decide to do it by the week. We didn't do it by the week last year, did we?
No.
Okay. Unless that was a change, it doesn't have to be. But anyways, so maybe leaving that as is, so we're not making it. The buses, we've really got nailed on buses for sure.
And
I don't know if we want to consider something like paying for both buses, for both the field trip and the pool bus.
That's what we discussed.
But
it's all rolled into one.
Right.
That's what you discussed.
But what about the kids that are not going to be in the bus? Because I think you guys are talking about all inclusive, right? So like
they
pay all that.
5 a week.
Okay.
And all inclusive, so they don't have to $100. Couple of days for us. So
a whole thing. So you're just being paid up front. It's not like built in, it's not like baked into the tuition?
It's baked into the tuition. So now I'm paying for weeks 1, 6, and 3.
Okay.
And I pay that tuition per week, but my bus fees are rolled into that tuition. So they're not dealing with $5 every once a week or twice a week or whatever it is.
So
you're already paying for the week that you are. You're not paying for anything you don't use.
Okay, that was my concern. I didn't know. I was kind of hearing something like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Unless you do pay for the full summer because it's less expensive for full summer versus paying by the week for 6 weeks, say.
Right.
So you would be donating towards a bus fee. But if you know, if you took our bus, does anybody have that number? What our bus expense was for the whole summer?
Because if you divided it up by all the campers, mm-hmm. I think it was like $3,000, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's $250 for a lake day because it's 8 hours. And then it was like $125 for a pool day. So it worked mm-hmm. out to be a little over $3,000, I believe.
Right. So if you do that divided by 70, whatever, 8 campers.
$17.43 for the cost of the 8 campers.
Yeah. So. So you add the $40 per person in there, then that's basically keeping the bus fee actually less than $5 a bus trip, right?
I think you're going to get a lot more kids paying by the week. The volume of kids, I think, is going to be higher if you're allowed to pay by the week now and be paying on credit card. So with the new software that we, sorry, not everybody's not up to speed, we got new software. And it was approved last week, and it's through Sports Engine. And
is that the name of it?
Sports Engine is the company.
Oh, okay.
But it'll be Camp Raleigh something or other. I have an onboarding video thingy next week with the guy, or girl, I don't know who is it. And then you guys will be webmasters. The three of you will be webmasters and have access to everything. And then we can pick and choose on what we want.
I don't think I want to be a webmaster.
Okay.
I'd like to bail on webmaster title.
Totally fine.
Thank you.
Totally fine. yeah, so then and we can design it. They're going to help us design it, and they'll be able to pick and choose their weeks. They will sign all their forms online, all your consent forms and everything online as well. It could break down everything, what shirt size you want, and all that jazz. So, and they do that all online, and they pay, and there's also an option that a parent can buy insurance, and say their kid breaks a leg and can't go for the whole summer. The insurance company pays the parent back. We still get to keep what they paid, so we don't lose out on any money if a parent wants a refund. So if a parent wants a refund, the insurance company pays.
So is that an extra fee for the parents to get able to choose that? Do you know what that is by any chance?
It depends on how many campers or how many pages we set up or whatever, or how much our fees are. So like a hockey team, it was like $21. Like he gave me examples. So ours is probably going to be less than that.
Are you guys going to sell snacks again this year?
We haven't gotten that far.
If there's a way for a parent to pay for snacks, like
we wanted last year mid-season to have like an index card system and just go off.
Maybe
writing it down, right? And there was discussion about that last year, and there was concern from committee members that if they give their kids a bulk rate, every day their kid's going to say, oh, I have $25 on my card. I'm going to buy a snack for every single
That's
one of my friends.
Says he buys stuff for everybody.
Which is awesome. It's nice to be generous, but I'm not that generous.
And at the end of the week, the kid would be out of money,
mm-hmm. yeah,
because of the first week or whatever, because they would have bought snacks for everybody.
Okay.
And on the flip side, I don't want my kid getting snacks.
Yeah.
Extra snacks that I don't know that they're having,
mm-hmm.
because
okay.
And then I go home and give them more ice cream or whatever, and it's like, oh. So that would be up to the counselors.
Well,
a snack
got
today.
3,000 calories today, and you're cut off. Yeah.
Okay. Like you're allowed, like in at the parent would tell the counselors, I only want my kid to have Freeze Pops and I don't know gummies. They're allergic to cupcakes or whatever.
All right.
Yeah. They have it on their cards anyway. That you know, if you're gluten free, if you're diabetic, whatever. So at our December meeting, on the very last page of the minutes. Which is only half a page, it does say those in attendance that night would like to recommend the following weekly prices for the committee to vote on, with the intention that all fees will be paid up front for the weeks noted when campers will be attending for those paying by the week.
What page do you want
to listen to? I have no idea.
I feel like I have a few pages.
So how much was it a week? Did you guys come up with 50 or 40 or what is
55
it?
Per week per check.
I think it doesn't, as a base, it doesn't include if they want to go on.
No, that includes your bedrooms.
Is that true?
Yeah.
I would like to revisit that number. Because, if we haven't set our regular fee, it's hard to talk about that right now.
And that, we spent a lot of time in December talking about that. It was before us, and we had set the regular fee at $45 a week.
I just want to go and if you revisit, and I think Jody, we talked about this, like if you revisit what other programs are doing, if you go to Barrington's.
Hold on. Did you guys talk about how many?
Is it on
there? Oh, we have not discussed field trips yet. Okay, but we're trying to set the price and we need to discuss field trips. We were approached by somebody at the school to make sure we set a date so it doesn't conflict with special ed.
So I don't know if this is a good time to then talk about that. And of course, now I have my. I just know the other programs which might be on here, what you wrote down, Celia, is that everybody charges a huge amount more by week.
So,
Barrington
was $63.10.
Oh, Barrington was like $150 a week.
Yeah.
Barrington was 60% more.
Yes.
Than what it would have been.
Right.
What's your goal number?
I don't think I find this.
My goal number for just tuition alone, just strictly tuition, is to keep it under 300 even after year. That would be my goal.
So Kelly,
290 for me.
On this page,
I'm 290 for me, and then 265.
On one page, I did put in the Barrington, because we touched on the Barrington, and how much they were. If you bought the whole summer, it was 510, and that would be $63.10 a week.
Yeah.
If you bought by the week for a resident, it's $150.
Right.
If you were a non-resident, it was $610 or $76.25 a week if you bought all 8 weeks.
Yep.
But it was $250 per week.
Yeah.
And so that works out to be 3 weeks if you're a resident before you, 3.5 before you hit the 510, or 2.5 before you hit the 610 for an out-of-town resident.
Right.
Does your 300 include the
$40 for the $40.
Mine was
just strictly the base tuition.
Okay.
Strictly the base.
So that's additional $40 registration and whatever you need to pay for the t-shirt as well.
Mm-hmm.
So your total goal is
410.
Okay.
Yeah. So
your
total goal is 410.
Where are you basing that? So that's base.
300 for your goal plus
290.
290. And then 80 for your bus and then $30 registration.
So now your goal is 40.
It's 40 for the one time.
You have
two trips a week.
No.
One and a half.
It's still a bus. But buses to the pool is
less. But that's going to charge them $2.50?
But yeah, that's also assuming that they're actually going to go on the bus. It's people actually, the kids are actually going to partake, right? So you're just saying.
When we figured out the bus money, Jody, we only figured out $40 per kid. Extra.
Right. And then we didn't want to have to deal with the $5 and stuff.
Right.
So
but
it,
but
so
I rolled 40 bucks. In. No. Because I looked at I looked at the final number. So, final transportation number was whatever it was, $3,000-something.
Mm-hmm.
And if we divided it by our, I think I only did like 75 kids. What does anybody have that number? 3,000? I roughly did that. 3,000 divided by 75 campers. It comes to $40 per kid for both trips. So that's why it's cheaper to do the all-inclusive, really.
Cheaper for them?
Yes.
Okay.
I know Jody, or Kelly, at the December meeting, you kept on saying $40 is what we need to cover the bus.
Per person.
Per child.
So, Jody, when we jumped to the two kid per family, it was a plus 80 because it was the 40 per kid.
Okay, so your goal is
Does that make sense to everybody?
So you'll be charging, so you're breaking out by child, but does that mean, I'm sorry, I'm sure I already asked this question, but does that mean that you're charging each camper that $40 to cover, even if they don't take the bus, it's going to cover?
Yeah, so like when I ran my numbers with the 320, it was plus a 40 for bus,
okay,
which came to 360, plus a $40 flat registration, right? So for one kid, it was 400. So for you, what you want with the 290, that would be $30 less, essentially, right? If we started this at 290 plus 40 is 330 plus another 40 is 370. Does everybody follow me there? So this number here would be 370. Now, when I ran the 16 two-kid families that we had, we did a $5 off per week for the second child, and then I charged 80 for the bus because it was two kids. That's how I came up with that, with a $40 registration. So that's how that
feels right with me now.
So this would be less with D's numbers. So I'd have to.
So I did the same thing you did, Kelly, and that's what my thing shows from when we talked in December.
So it was 40 for the first child and then 80 for the bus.
So we did 320,
yep,
plus 40.
Yeah.
And then the $40 registration fee.
Yeah.
And so that's what
came up with the 400.
Came up with,
yep,
the 400. And that breaks down to $45 a week cost. And then we took that number and we took the family discount,
yep,
of $5 a week, and it was 320 plus
280
plus 360, and we came up with 680, and that cost was $45 a week, or $85 a week, and your registration, so your total would be 720. And then for families of three or more, we had a big discussion that there was only one last year, but there could be more coming up, that it was 730. And that would cover, that $50 more for the third sibling would cover the bus.
I didn't remember what we talked about.
I've just been watching it for like the last week. So ensuring that I get it all in the list.
Well, with the second checkbook that was found,
yeah,
it had $1,000 in it,
yeah,
and 200 of it was spent on the software.
Nice.
So now you have $800 of revenue that you didn't have. So if you want to use that towards this camp, then it's still going to revenue.
We also, even with the numbers everybody ran, that comes up revenue.
Well, it still has to come out revenue neutral no matter what, but at least you have money to play with now to lower the costs if you want to lower the costs.
Well, I definitely think we should. I mean, I'm just really worried about.
So you don't like $55 a week? Because the registering.
Well, by the week, you mean?
Yeah, by the week.
No, actually, I didn't mind that. I don't mind the week by the week at all. I mean, that one sounds fair. I just.
So okay.
There's something, I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm not getting myself there or something. I'm not, my
You're
head
missing.
Isn't wrapping around something, but I feel like there should be buckets. I feel like what we did last year, there was absolutely nothing wrong with it in terms of the structure that we had. So we did tuition buckets, we did registration buckets, we did free buckets, we did bus buckets. But now it sounds like everything's going to be combined together. And I kind of have a problem with that because that means in some ways we're paying for somebody else in some respects. If that makes sense. Because you guys are saying it's not an all-inclusive, but yet to me it keeps sounding like it's an all-inclusive.
So it is an all-inclusive.
Okay.
$55 per year includes the bus fee.
Okay.
Yeah,
can
a t-shirt.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's low,
personally.
That's my thought.
Yeah,
I think
so
that's
the
low.
Registration fee is going to cover their t-shirt, whether they have one kid or two kids.
Okay.
Or
it is a really affordable. $380 is very affordable. It's very, very, very affordable. Compared, like you said, it's so affordable compared to the other things. But
I mean,
I see what you're saying too.
Yeah,
it just,
I
just
didn't
even
get this
where
we did.
It just adds a lot more work. But I mean, hard. I could see like all these young adults like scrambling, like, oh, I have money, and this is money there, and this is money here, and I just felt kind of bad for you guys.
That was there wasn't communication between certain people last summer.
Like, I just felt bad for you guys, and like, oh, who are you going to give money to? And they're like, oh, I don't know. And
I definitely think that should be fixed.
Yeah,
for sure.
Because the parents don't have confidence in it, and like when they're handing over money, it's like, oh, where's it going to go? So not in the people.
And the problem with that too, also what we've come to find out is with the auditors for the town, that they did not like the $5 cash input, and who paid for that and who didn't pay for that, and where did that go? So to make it easier on the town, the all-inclusive aspect of it, they like a lot more.
All right, so based on the numbers that you guys ran, what is the anticipated
income? I want everybody to have perspective, and not that we're running the works camp, and not that we have their facility, but their members per week for their kids are $205 a week, $245 for non-members a week.
Yeah, and Sedgwick's Worth with no building at all,
outside
of the pavilion, is $125,
$130. Yep, right. It's in here. Celia, in here, do you know what the projected income is based on all of them?
We did not run income because we spent a lot of time discussing weeks versus camps. There's a whole, we talked about sessions like Summersworth does, for 4 week sessions, 2 4-week sessions and so forth. But we did not talk about income. We just talked about what the cost was per family.
So how's this?
You like the $55 by the week.
Mm-hmm.
Your goal is to make it $370 for the family. $300 goal, $40 bus, $30 registration. $40 registration.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Sorry, $40 registration. So that's what you're with your $290, which would just be tuition, correct?
Sounds about right.
Okay. So $55 per week,
mm-hmm,
for 8 weeks is $440 plus the $40 registration, which would be $480.
Okay.
So would you, if they pay for all 8 weeks, they get the discount and get the $370. And then if you want to buy by the week, you have to pay $55.
Could that be given some personal
to do D's number, let's go with, so D's number plus $40 for one kid would be $330 for the 8 weeks, and then we have
and then a registration
fee on top of that. So if you do that number, $330 divided by 8 is $41.25 a week, and that would be all inclusive, including your
field trips. Are you using the same t-shirts as this last year?
Well, yeah, we got
them. Please do that so I can find you more t-shirts.
Like,
problem with that is
the counselors will be a different color than the counselors.
Yeah.
We know that.
But we also don't know if CNJ is...
I have information about that.
Exciting.
We'll get that. Yeah.
We have so much information to share.
I would like to tell you the numbers that I ran, just so I can tell. So, I have the number of campers that we had, which was 76 last year. Although, we had two latecomers that I did not include. I know that was a couple hundred extra dollars, but... If we do all of our salaries, and this is with seven counselors being paid the $10 an hour that we discussed, Brittany, I don't know if you're all up to page on this, okay, up to speed. So what we decided in our last meeting was that we wanted everybody that was here last summer to be paid $10 an hour. And then there were three that we had talked about that were to get 11.
Two.
And you can't say that out loud. So let me see what you have to say.
Should I have initials? Can figure that out.
No, we got to put it on public.
Go into non-public.
A motion to go into non-public to discuss salaries.
Yes. Second.
Roll call.
No.
Yes. So
yeah.
Say yes.
Yes.
Yes, Kathy. Yes, Liberty.
Yes, Kathy.
Yes, Steve.
Yes, Jerry.
All right. Non-public.
You can't be in non-public.
Yes, we can.
No, not when you talk about people's wages. That's public information.
We're going into personnel.
But you can't talk about money.
We're going into personnel and staffing. But you know better. It just seemed to me that we were a little bit overstaffed. But you said it was
by the end of the summer, we had smaller numbers. Definitely, we were definitely overstaffed. I couldn't remember what the ratio. I know we were trying to meet a ratio last summer, and that's why we had so many. I think if we just do 1 to 10 or 1 to 12.
I don't feel comfortable with the other kids.
Is that too much?
Way too much.
Yeah, with the other kids probably not.
Then I think
at the works their ratio is 8 to 1. With campers entering the first grade. But it goes up to 10 to 1 for their third and fourth, fifth, and sixth graders.
Right. It's the younger kids. Yeah.
So 8 to 1. I think that's what we did last year. 8 to 1. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say
8
to 1.
Then we would still need 9 counselors. That's even 9.7, so realistically 10.
And so what if we start getting towards the end of the summer? Or what if, too, playing devil's advocate, we get people who are signing up by the week, and we realize that, wow, we've got double the staff and we don't need them. What are we going to do about that? Are we going to start, are we going to let them know that there's a possibility that they
may not
work?
Offer them time off, because
I don't know, but I don't know about how the kids are, but, if someone says, hey, you don't have to come in tomorrow,
you're usually pretty excited about it, because we're done.
So I think last year.
And they take time off anyway.
Right.
A lot of them, at the end of the summer, were doing sports stuff anyways, so it was easier to just say, hey, take today off so you don't have to do this in doubles tomorrow or something.
Right. But then will they still get paid? Or?
No, they take time off, they're not getting paid. But I remember being that age, and I was happy to have a day off. Mm-hmm. Like, I know I signed up for full time.
Like, getting days
sleep.
Off? Like a day here and there,
yeah,
they appreciate it, but I don't know how they would feel about their week.
Right,
then they would
believe
in
it. Right. Yeah, but
so
just they get a day here.
Yeah,
like, hey, I'm not going to need it tomorrow or whatever.
Yeah, so it's
or,
something.
Hey, you want to go home early?
Yeah.
morning I thought was overstaffed. The pre-care was overstaffed. So
it was the transitioning. People were coming in 15 minutes early, and it was supposed to just be me. And no, you're right, you had two.
No, he had three there last year, and that wasn't, like, when we originally designed it that way, that was one of the things that I had on my list to talk to you about this year, is that we had 16 kids, that's why we maxed out at pre and post, so that we would only have to have two counselors there.
That's why there were three, because he wasn't counting himself.
Right.
Yes.
And that's why we had you guys got the 40 hours a week, so that you, one of you would be there for the morning shift and one would be there at the closing shift with one other counselor. So that was kind of our design.
Is anybody interested in a 7:30 start?
I was interested in a 5:30 finish. I know that too.
And that's Brittany built up this past week. I see the appeal. A lot of miscommunication happened when one of us wasn't there. I mean, yes, we are better at talking to each other, but those are the really busy times where parents are kind of latching on to us, trying to find information from us and whatever. So it gets a little tricky trying to balance that and checking the kids out sometimes, but I think it would be fine because we would pick up more kids. It would just
For a 7:30 start, you mean?
Or a 5:30 finish. Either way, would be a little tricky. And if, especially if you did both, because we're maxed at 40 hours. So one of us would be there without the other for almost an hour and a half. So at the busiest time of the day.
You would get more people coming. They could drop them off before they go to work. Like some people start at work.
Maybe not the 5:30, but definitely
you've approached yourself.
I've approached myself. So if we had a choice, would we do 7:30 or the 5:30? If we had a choice.
Yeah, Jody. We'll ask Jody that one.
I need the 7:30.
That was more important than the 5:30 pickup.
Because if it's 7:30, that means somebody needs to be there at like 7:15.
Jump to 70.
70 for out of town. And 135 for the second kid.
And those are the same discounts we've been giving along the way, $5 each week for the second child.
I just, just to be argumentative, because that's how I'm feeling today, I guess.
That's fine.
just seeing what other camps do, how they jump from, I mean, I'm not saying we should go that way, but I worry about this in that.
That's too low.
I think it's too low.
Okay.
Yeah.
It doesn't cover the salary even.
Right.
Yeah. Or, yeah.
I think I had come up with, when I was looking at it, like 50% more per week. So it was like 60, it was like 62 or 63 or something like that, maybe even 65.
I even, just for fun, went to 80 a week for in-town and 100 out-of-town. Because at some point you need to have, like, so if we're going with D's number on the 3, what did we come up with? 330 was without registration, right? And so would we say that, and I don't think we need to be as extreme as Barrington. I think that's just, I thought they were a little bit much, but if we go, we would want people to at least try to be
so
here
we worked
for
it out.
4 weeks, you know, or
yeah,
whatever it is to, you know, to get the discount.
So at the meeting in December, Jody did throw out the number 75 per week, and we worked out that numbers for 3, 4, 5 weeks. And for 4 weeks, it's $300 at 75 per week. For 5 weeks, it's 375. 6 weeks is 450. 5 weeks is
$725
per child.
Cheaper by the week if you're only going to come for half the summer still, right?
Yeah, 6 weeks or less. You're going to come for more than 6 weeks, you
just
pay
all of it.
Right.
You should definitely raise it.
The weekly?
Yes.
It worked out 65, I think. Because it was 60, just straight tuition, it was 65 at 4 weeks, 360. Because in my mind, like Jody was saying, you want to encourage them to
pay everything up front.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And you get so much. Like, you couldn't believe like how much you were getting. I felt it was such a value. Like, yeah. You're like, how many 2 weeks? You're going to pay more.
That's what I should make.
Yeah.
No, what was it? 60? Barrington was 60% more.
Oh, it was way.
Yeah.
And I don't think we need to do that.
No.
That's crazy. But, yeah, they were more than double their, you know, what you said, 60%.
So their tuition
yeah,
was
more
six,
than double.
610, and it was 187 a week. It's crazy.
Mm.
I say 65.
Feel better about that than the 55.
You want to keep in town at 55 and out of town at 80. So then they pay our costs? Because our taxpayer money.
Right.
Whenever we screw up, we have to come up with a cover.
And
anyway.
I definitely agree with what you're saying, for sure. But my mind goes back to how many out of towners we actually had versus how many.
And I can tell you,
I think with the priority start, we had more. And how many did we have?
Last year we had 9 single kids from out of town and 3 2-kid families from out of town. So we had a total of 15 kids from out of town.
And one of them isn't coming back because they moved to Texas.
So I guess my only point there would be that we're getting more money from
our in-town
people. I mean, yes, I'm sure we're going to pick up some, hopefully we'll pick up some out-of-towners because the rates are higher, I mean, just to be honest, but I can't guarantee money. If I play devil's advocate, most, like you said, the worst is $100 or $200 a week. Barrington, we know, is $150 to $250 a week.
Mm-hmm.
Somersworth is $100 a week for residents, $125 for out-of-town. So if we do 55 a week, we're much cheaper, and we're going to be pulling in,
hopefully
some of those families from out of town at $70 a week.
So you're saying $70 out of town?
Yeah, $70 out of town.
Okay, questions for me.
But that's, I have 100 out of town before, so
right,
I had 80 in town, but I think that's we, what about, what if we do something like what Dee said, 65 and 80? 65 in town, 80 out of town.
There was a concern that, at our December meeting, that if we raised it too high, that we're going to be pricing a bunch of the families that just want to pick a week here and a week there out of it.
But you're still, if we were at, like, we're here with 65 times 4, if they decided to come for 4 weeks, half the summer, it's still $260, so it's still, they're still getting
a value
that's less than the full summer.
Can we split the difference in 6? 60? 10? Just because it looks better.
60 and what?
75? So that's what I meant about the 290 giving out a 300, because it looks better, right? So it's got a better look.
Yeah. Like, except it's really not 290 because we're adding a bus into it, so it's really 300.
Well, 290, the 290 was for just the regular, it's for regular, not, it wasn't early bird. My early bird was a different, it's $25 less than that.
That was going to be a nightmare site if you also kind of threw up.
I know. So 60 times.
So 60 and 75? How do other people feel about that? So do you
have 60 and 75?
So they could still, kids, people can come for 5 weeks and still pay.
Promotion for 60, 80.
Less.
60, 80?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I'll second that. What is our second child rate?
We would do $5 less. So if we're going with 60 for in town, it would be 55 for the second child. So what's that? 110? 115, sorry. Let me make sure I'm 60 plus 55 is 115. 115. And what did you say for 80? 80? 80 and 75? Anyone quick? 125? Go.
60 dollars a week for in-town residents. 150 for out-of-town residents. $80 for out-of-town residents. Mm-hmm. Second child, in-town residents is 150 a week. Out-of-town residents is 25 a week.
And you seconded that one, Jack.
Okay.
I would agree.
I just 3+.
It is. What was the discussion on the 3+? I think it was me. It was free.
we did you in the whole summer.
I was the only 3 family in the whole kingdom.
But
and
I do know that.
Every time I ran the numbers on that, it was just one single family.
I do know that there is another one or two families.
All right, so if we did 3+, I
get
5 in the summer.
Still a 5 hour break?
If the teen camp.
Oh,
she might be able to put coffee.
I can't
Is it a 5 hour break for 3+?
I don't know what we just added.
But we did not go 3+ because
we didn't have a break.
She was the only one. And we gave a nice big round. We gave her a break on the whole summer,
which
it was
really nice. It was really nice.
So we only raised the tuition over in 2 kids by $50 to cover the bus and the t-shirt. So anything over 2 kids was a $50 additional charge.
Is that what we did? I couldn't remember what we did.
Yeah.
It was saving the 7:30.
And that would cover your bus. And so, since there were such a low number of families with 3 children in 2017, it was agreed that an additional $50 beyond the second child discount in Camp Fear would cover those families. It was noted that the families were 3 or more. It's not much more than that of 2 children families, and the families with 3 or more would have the bus fees and t-shirts, including the Mayor Family pricing, at 7:30. And that was for 7:30 is based on in-town residents, and it would be 8:30 for the families of Cherry Morton.
Is that including the registration fee?
It's 7:70 with registration fee. And if you broke it down, we said it was $255 per child for three kids at 7:30, and 8 weeks, that's $91.25 for, or, so it's $32 a week for a child.
And actually, if we're switching to $290 a week, are we, is that still in discussion?
We still have to make this, yes,
because
we haven't voted your child yet. Now.
Is this for the weekly?
Okay.
In favor of these pricing
for the week.
For the weekly.
So if I get this right.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Only talk about 1 and 2 child right now.
1 and 2 child. So 60 in town, 4 weeks would be.
Don't do the math.
Don't do the math.
That's not what.
No,
right,
this is the weekly pricing.
Yes.
Well, let's figure out how much it costs.
Well, I want to think in my head, are we giving them savings?
Absolutely.
Before I vote.
It's $240. 6 is 4.
What do you want to know, Celia? I'll tell you.
When is the point where the summer camp becomes more affordable?
Okay. So for 4 weeks at that, it's $240. So at 5 weeks, it's the 300.
Right there is where it becomes more affordable.
So
if we go
by $10.
If we go with what Dee suggested earlier, which we haven't voted
in
yet.
We haven't voted on. But
so
that, so with the 290, now, that was not including your bus, but right? I just want to make sure.
Those
I know.
So
330. Okay. So Dee would actually be 330 without the registration fee. So you're still getting a discount for 5 weeks of weekly. It's when you go 6, 7, or 8 weeks is when it's cheaper to do
but
full summer.
But sometimes it's easier for families to pay by the week.
Right.
And
yeah,
put
absolutely
it on their, because they're going to be able to punch it in, saying, I'll buy this and this, and the software is going to send them a reminder.
That's awesome.
Yes.
So is so. I don't.
So you're
I
not.
I don't want you to go. I don't want to go into a tangent here. So let's just focus on this for a second. Can I have a question about that?
Well, you can do that. I'll figure out.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
while you're
so would it be they have to pay a week in advance, or we can set it up to whatever we want?
We're gonna set. They have to pay for at least 2 weeks plus the registration fee, and then whatever other weeks they're paying for, the computer will prompt them that you have to pay by the Wednesday before the week following.
Right, so that's going to change how we do things in terms of collectively. So there's no really no cutoff anymore. There's no we need to be paid 100% by June 12th.
Right,
we're going to do a pay a week.
So your cutoff would only come in if you're paying for the whole summer.
See, that's different than what was discussed in December. It's like it would be paid up front.
Because we didn't have the software. And we didn't know
right.
We could get the software.
If they were paid by week, could I have random kids show up like halfway through the week? Do you know what I mean? Like if they're paying the week before they come, could I have kids register Wednesday before and then
they
show up?
No, registration
okay.
Cuts off.
Okay.
Yeah, registration cuts off. So you're going to know who's
question.
Coming on week 5.
Okay.
On week 1.
Okay.
And the computer's going to prompt the parents to pay on week 4 for week 5.
All right. So, okay.
So you have to pick your weeks in advance, but
yes.
You don't necessarily have to.
So as far as staffing is concerned, we still have a heads up?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. You're not going to have any surprises.
Yes.
Good question.
Okay, Celia.
So I'm thinking $80 for the out-of-town.
Yep.
Yeah.
4 weeks
is
320. And then we've got
so
400.
We've traditionally always we've done $100 more for out of town people. So for with D on that, the 330, it would be a 430 for the out of town. That's not registration fee included. I'm going without registration fee. So it would be. Well, there's only 9 of them. So at 80 times 4, that's 320. So, yeah, it would be the same thing. So 5 weeks, still up to 5 weeks, they're getting a saving. So anything more than six, seven, or eight, it's cheaper to buy into the whole summer. Child with D's. So should we, I feel like we're going all over the place here with what we're talking about. Because we, if this is what we want to do, then we should.
Well, that's up for vote.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe you guys should vote on it first before.
And my question is, does this include registration? If this is just, and then the $40 registration is above and beyond. Yes, one time.
Yes, we are.
Yes.
We are only. We're talking without. Every number we've discussed so far is without registration.
So,
is that? Are you good with that? So $290 plus the $40 for one child would come to the $330.
Are you making that? You're making everybody pay that?
Yes.
Everybody.
Everybody.
Regardless of whether they take the bus or not.
Absolutely.
That's not what Jody said, though. Jody said we're not making them pay for anything.
Well, that's if you pay by the week. We have to somehow do it for the full people who are going to pay it for the full summer.
Okay. So, yes. That's
right.
You're buying into the option of taking the field trip. If you don't take the field trip, that's on you. And you have to take some personal responsibility somewhere. If it's, yeah.
Well, I'm good with it, so.
Okay.
I'm good to go if you want.
Okay.
We're only on the week right now, by the way.
The thing is, so if we're calculating weekly stuff, but looking at this about when the weekly stuff, you know, becomes more affordable, but we hadn't voted what her suggestion was.
So now we know what the difference between mine and what you guys had originally come up with, so just put it to a vote if you want to do.
I'm okay.
You guys are okay with that.
So, okay.
Okay, I feel better now. I put all the numbers down on paper. For just the weekly thing. I'm sorry.
I don't even know what to go with here. Okay.
So
can we vote on this weekly thing? Most people understand the weekly?
Yeah.
I'm basing it off of Dee's new numbers, so then I guess we have to go back to that at some point. But.
Well, let's vote on this and then we'll go back to the numbers.
Okay.
Yes. So the motion was made for $60 in town and $80 out of town, with the second child in town being $155 and the second child out of town being
it's the other way. It's $115 and
$155. Yeah. $115 for the second child in town and $155 for the second child out of town, representing a $5 head discount for the second child.
Yes.
All in favor of this motion?
All in favor.
Aye.
Aye.
I'm going with that. Any nays or opposed? No.
Oh, we got something done.
Thank
okay, now we've got that, so now we can work
okay.
on this. Does this make sense, or does what you guys have proposed back in the summer make sense?
Now let's go to your own.
My own.
We're all inclusive.
I wasn't all inclusive.
So you're saying
I wasn't in favor
of
all inclusive. Well, I just keep going back to the way I had it laid out, the $290 for paying tuition, and then your add-ons is fine. And so the way that you have presented it, like this is fine.
Okay.
So that works.
Okay.
Now that we've got there. But now there's a difference between what this was and what you guys had originally worked out in December, so it's a matter of voting on.
So it actually goes down. So if we were looking at originally $360 per a single, with what Dee wanted would be $330. So that would go down by $30.
And then a $40 registration fee.
Yes. So the total pricing, Liberty, do you have one child?
I do.
I have
another one.
What do you think about the $370?
I think it's amazing. I think it's so affordable.
And if you look at camps like some Berwick and like the worst, that's one or 2 weeks.
It's right up there now.
Oh,
it's over here.
Even with two, like if I sent them both, I don't know, do you guys take 5-year-olds? Going to take 5 years?
If they're in kindergarten.
Are they going into
either way, even if you had to go to, like, that, I would pay that in a heartbeat. Yeah.
Okay.
And it's not like we have a lot of money.
It's
just so affordable. Yeah.
So, Kelly,
you
said this breaks down to be $36 and change. Right?
Yeah, I'm going with, so it's.
It's 8 weeks.
So $330.
I'm really counting.
No, it's $41.25. It's $41.25 a week.
So that's not far from where we were.
Yeah. So if what I just did was take the 330 divided by 8 is the 4125. So for our second child discount, we've given them $5 off. So if you subtract $5 from that, it's $36.25 per week, which if you do that times 8 comes to $290. So the first child is $330 plus $290 for the second child. Now this is where we added $80 for bus fees for two children. So that comes to $700 even for two kids.
And that's $20 more than what we had suggested in December. We had suggested $680 for two kids.
So what did I miss there? Because I had $720.
Oh,
for two.
I didn't include the $40 registration fee. Does yours right now include the $40? No, it doesn't.
Oh, so the $40 registration fee, I think it would have been the $720, which is what I was coming up with.
But you just added $80. I only added $40.
Well, two bus fees.
Yeah, you got it. We got to do the two bus fees.
So that's
and there's no, we can't discount that because we didn't discount that before.
And then
right?
The $40 registration, so it comes out to be $740, which was $20 more than what we had suggested in December. I'm doable with that.
Yeah.
So $740 for two kids.
Yep.
In town.
And that includes registration, Jody. So it's $700
okay.
Even without the registration fee.
So, we're not, this is not a motion yet. If we go back, $740 for the whole summer is two kids. It's
out of town?
In town.
Oh, this is still in town.
That is like,
it's $46.25 a week per kid.
You would get 6 weeks if you paid by the week cheaper. So you would get the two, because it's $690 for two kids if you pay by the week.
For 6 weeks.
And then it jumps to $805 when you add in the next.
You're also securing a spot for your kids for 8 weeks if you're paying for, you know, like you know for sure they have a place to go for less than $10 a day. You know, if you pay, like that's the security, you're paying for security up front.
Yeah, but I know like Jody and I talked in December, I know certain weeks I'm out of town, and I'm sure she knows which week she's going on vacation over the summer, and so that's why we want to give people
the option both ways.
Because I know every week, the second week of August, which is probably the last week of camp, I'm at my parents' house for the month.
So let's go back to the beginning. So 290. So let's go back to the beginning. So one child is 290 plus 40 for the bus plus 40 for registration.
Yeah.
Right.
And that works out to be $41.25 a week.
Okay.
So it's 330 for one kid in town, 700 for two kids in town, plus the $40.
Do we want to make, I know, so I'm just going to 30 times. Yeah. Well, how many weeks did it take us to get to, by paying by the week to get to, was it only five? For the single?
For the in-child, because at 6 weeks you go to 360 and at 5 weeks you're at 330.
No,
so do we somehow want to try and do that with the two kids? Or do we really? Is everybody? everybody good with this number?
$700?
Yeah. Even though if you buy the week, you know.
You get 6 weeks before you hit the 700.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, even if I had to pay all 8 weeks, it's easier for me to pay $60 a week than it is for me to come up with $700 all at once.
Right.
My budget just doesn't allow it. I pay for not having that in the bank ready to go.
And if she's going to pay by the week, the camp in the end is going to make out. Instead of bringing in $700 or $740 for her two kids, we'll bring in $920 if they go all the way 8 weeks, which is highly unlikely because I'm sure she's got a vacation or two planned in there. But we would make out more if they choose by the week.
Okay. We're not doing the 3+?
We already made a motion to accept that the 1 and the 2, but not the 3.
So we're not doing that.
Okay. They'll pay by the week.
No, I mean for this too, for the summer.
We did a $50 additional fee for three or more children.
So would we do a 3 more kids for the week, or are we just going to kind of... I probably won't buy it. I just thought I
should. So if we did, that would be $790 with everything included.
Yeah.
With your bus fee and your registration. And we have to have $45 or $46.
Wait, where did you get $790?
Oh, for the third kid.
For the third kid.
Oh.
Sorry. $790 if we add $50, and that'll cover $40 for their busing fees for the summer, and bring in $7 for their teacher.
Yeah.
And it'll give us $3 extra.
Yeah. Okay.
So is it?
Make a motion for, sorry.
Oh, before I go on, is it $50 per child over two, or is it 3 or more, is just one price? Say you get a family of 4.
I think you have to go 50
each
kid over.
Yeah.
How are you going to do that on our software?
I have no idea. I'll let them figure
just
that out.
Just charge me.
I'll let you know. Then you have to do it. Then you can't do it on the computer. You have to walk in with your paper and check. I don't know. They said that they could pretty much do everything, so I'm not worried about it yet.
So I make a motion that the 8-week camp tuition will be $290, a $40 bus fee, and a $40 registration fee for a total of $370 for one child in town. A second child would be at $290, which would bring the tuition fee up to $620, a bus fee of $80, $40 per child, and one flat rate registration of $40 for a total of $740 for two kids. Three kids would be $790, and each additional child would be $50 more. I need a second.
Second.
Can I ask
the
question?
Yeah, because I'm asking you on the question too, because
what's the early bird for this?
So I'm just looking. So doing the math, right? It doubles the single, which is weird. So I don't know why.
It does.
So why is that? Because we gave a discount for the second child. So the confusion is why. Right. Oh, you know why? Because we doubled. We put the 330 first, where the 330 was with the bus.
Sorry.
So we did a 3-bus charge on that one. So it should be less. Did you see that? Did you follow me there?
Yes. We added the bus twice on the second child.
Yes.
So that they paid the fee for the bus.
three times instead of two.
Yes. So that's because I was like, why isn't that not, that's not cheaper. It should be cheaper. Because we gave a, it's a $40 off essentially for the second child. So it should come to $700 total.
So the bus fee, do you drop that down to 40, or do you drop the tuition for the first one, the 290?
So if we started with 290, then that's got to be the change. So 290 divided by 8 is, well, that's where we got the 3625. So minus 5 would be 3125. Doing the bus fee separately is confusing. So the rate, how it would go, would be 290 plus 250 for the second child plus the $80 for the busing. Does that make sense to everybody? Because I used 330 for my first number.
Right.
And then added, the busing again.
Yeah.
So that's why that didn't come out. So it's 290 plus 250.
So 540.
540 plus the 80 is 620.
Plus 40 for your flat rate registration brings you up to 660.
Yeah.
Instead of 740. Three or more would be 710.
Yeah.
If you added $50 to that. And then
the numbers still aren't making sense to me.
Six,
that
was
like,
oh,
that was last year.
Right.
Yeah.
What was it? 240.
620 plus 50 is 670 plus your $40 registration fee.
Yes, I'm putting that off to the side.
Okay. So based on that number, then we're back to 5 weeks for first or second child in Mass Ellen.
Okay, so that makes sense that way.
So yeah, you can pay for four. So it's cheaper to buy two children
up to 5 weeks.
Up to 5 weeks, because when you go 5 weeks, you're getting $575. It's all inclusive with your bus fee. And then you're getting $540 plus an $80 bus fee, which brings you up to $620.
Okay.
So do we have to amend that now that we changed it? Or?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So amend the motion to for a full summer rate of one child is $330 plus registration. Two child is $620 plus registration. Three or more children. 670. Three children is 670 plus registration. For each additional child above and beyond three would be $50 for four or more.
Plus registration for two kids or more.
$50 each child for four or more.
And it includes busing?
Yes.
How's everybody feeling about this?
$80 of it is just the bus.
Yeah.
You ended up paying it anyway.
Right.
Like,
what about the people who don't want to pay it? What about the people who are not going on the buses?
That's their problem.
Yeah, I think we just.
You mean they're keeping their kid home when they go on a field trip?
We didn't have many of those.
How
many people do we have of those? Do we have a lot of those?
No. But we are also paying when you got there.
Right.
Like, we were getting bus money that day. So it was a little trickier with that.
Right.
I can tell you, when the kids...
For the fee that they're paying,
I think I will be much happier with this tea, even.
Because trying to remember on Tuesday morning that I took off with $5, $10 was crazy.
Yeah.
Like, and then took the day the next day, and then, like, I couldn't remember.
I never have cash.
I literally had to scrounge for my pizza money one day in the car. I think I gave them all pennies or something.
They got pizza, they were happy.
All right. Okay. Go ahead, Kath, question.
Is that $50 for the fourth child going to cover the bus?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And the staff? Yeah.
Okay. It's going to cover the bus and the teacher.
Yeah, we just
have
them in the gym alone.
Okay. Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Our pricing.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Yay.
All right.
What would you like out
of it? Well, last year what we did was at $100. Does anybody want to change that? I mean, I think people were still thinking that it was reasonable for out of town people. Does anybody have thoughts one way or the other?
I would
higher or
just put it out like it. Is it an objection or something?
So we could just go with the $100 again.
Okay, so that would make out of town. I make a motion for out of town fees for all inclusive for the summer to be one child is $440, two children is $720, third child is $770, and four or more is still $50.
So
I'll second that plus the registration.
And just for discussion, so I'd like to and it's 4:30 or 4:40 for first child.
Oh, sorry.
4:30.
I'm so sorry.
So
let me remake that motion. Do I have to remake the whole motion?
No.
Okay. 4:30.
Correction. 4:30.
4:30 for one child. Count.
And that includes the registration?
No.
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 Plus $40 for registration, right?
Correct.
Yes.
So it would be 4:70.
I wonder if we should raise the out of town $50 to $55 or $60.
For what are you talking about?
I'm afraid that the computer software already. I don't know what it's going to be able to do or not do, so please don't make me add more buttons. I'm not sure that it will be able to handle.
Or since we didn't have any families over three from out of town, do we just not worry about it?
We should probably have something in place in case that occurs.
So if we're, yes, we're using
Maybe it was.
$100.
Yeah, raise it up $50 instead of $100.
Per kid over two?
Mm-hmm. Over three.
Well, isn't that what we did for three, though? We only added $50 for the third. Correct?
For in-town.
For in-town.
Yeah. So, for four or more.
It should really
town.
Be three or more, shouldn't it? It really
mm-hmm.
should be three or more.
Yeah, because the third one is $50 more. It's not, you're not paying another tuition cost. You're just paying the $50 for the bus and the t-shirt. So three or more should be $100.
Mm-hmm.
For each person, let's say they have six kids, so they pay the first and the second, and then they pay another $400 for their other four kids. Yeah.
Let's just hope that doesn't.
I'd like to amend the motion to be $100 per child for anything over three.
Yeah. A second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any nays? All right. Opposed? I guess I'm supposed to say.
All right, so through that, right? So are we done with tuition now?
Okay.
Super.
Yeah, I need a drink.
Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, what did you find out about the sponsorship with?
Okay,
let's go to happy news. Maybe.
So I finished putting I have it, so I remembered to put it in the list. Okay. Email, I printed out two copies from C&J. They want to know what we would like them to like us. I only brought one of these, but this is what. Do they want to know, are we keeping it the same as last year for t-shirts, or do we want to go up?
And you said it was $12.50, right?
It was $12.50 last year for C&J.
Do they want to know if we want to ask them for more money?
I know.
It says, hi, Sadie. Thank you for sharing the images. Do you have more information that you could share on the sponsorship? Is the cost for the shirt sponsorship the same as it was last year?
When they gave you that $12.50 last year, was it? Did they come up with that number, or is that something that you two?
We came up with that. So
okay.
what we decided last year, we can revisit that, was that Kristen, right? It's Kristen, had five spots on the back of the shirt that she could fit. So we were looking for $2.50 a sponsorship for the five spots on the t-shirt, and then C&J just said, "Well, I'll just buy them all."
Yeah. So if we don't change that level of sponsorship, so then we ask them, I don't know, do we ask for the same and push it a little bit?
I know.
Can always aim high.
Uh-huh.
First that can happen is they come back down a little bit to $12.50.
And they're doing great. The bus company's doing awesome. Ask them for more.
Yeah, it's $1,500 and the same thing.
Okay. I need a motion. Okay.
All in favor? All in favor for CA, ask for more money?
I need your balance. I'm going.
Any opposed?
I only heard one eye.
I think we all said aye really fast. I was really hoping that Shayna was going to be here.
Oh, I have information.
Oh, good, because I had reached out to. I was hoping to be at the PTO meeting on Tuesday, and then I couldn't go because I ended up in Portland for a basketball game that wasn't on the schedule. So we looked at this. The PTO, from the quick exchange I've had with them, has been they're very positive about wanting to do this with us. My thought right now is, being February 11th, there's no way we're going to be able to do March, because what we have to do is have a collection of these gift cards or whatever. We have to put it on a calendar, and then we have to sell the calendars. So my idea would be to do April.
So their suggestion was.
So were you there on Tuesday?
I did. I went Tuesday night.
Okay.
Their idea was, instead of us
splitting the proceeds and the work. They have a staff member at the school who loves to do this thing, type of thing, and they also have the availability of the parents and wanting to know if there's a theme, if there's a limit, and all of that. So they suggested instead that instead of trying to coordinate something that would possibly cause more work for everybody involved, that maybe they just send an email out to the parents and get gift cards or come up with their own calendar, sell the calendars to the school, and then any committee members that wanted to sell them could in the community, and then they would give us a donation of the proceeds. So they would set up the calendar and sell it. They would be and it would be like a sponsorship donation where we would get 50% of the proceeds from the calendar.
Well, gee, I'm all in favor of that.
They're willing to do all the work, sell all the stuff,
and give us money.
Mine, yes.
I know. Sounds like a win-win for everybody on that.
So
one.
They want to make sure that they were clear in asking the questions and making sure that they were clear and saying that the sponsorship would be coming from them and that they get to do the work and stuff. Because they could put it out to the parents and like say, we're looking for gift cards for $25 or something, instead of having to come to us and say, who do you have gift cards from and all of that.
So. Sounds great.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Thank you.
Okay. So,
thank you,
is it 50% though? Is that what they wanted to do? So
they said a donation, but
yeah.
They were thinking about
it. But if we have to do no work, even
whatever they want to give us is
yeah.
fine
yeah.
at this point. Would be awesome.
I think that's awesome.
So,
whatever.
I will make the motion to send an email to the.
Do we need a motion?
No.
Okay, good.
If you want one, you can have one.
But she was, Shane was supposed to be here tonight.
Right, I thought so. That was the information I got. So.
Well, her two little ones are sick. They were supposed to be at softball with me.
And
so.
Have you guys discussed like what's the on the calendar for the like what the activities are going to be or not yet?
Not yet. We
okay.
just have a bunch of ideas. If you want to throw some at me, I can write them down.
Okay. Well, I don't know like what time do you guys. I don't want to keep on adding time to it. If there was something else that you guys wanted to talk about.
I do have two quick things. This is our letter from last year. Do we want to for sponsorships? Do we want to change any of the numbers now that we have new camp prices?
No, I would leave those the same. That's my opinion, though.
So just change where it says Wallingford Summer Rec 2017 to 2018?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Don't make the words for
myself. I think, Celia, when you approach C&J, I think you need to say to them again, if you are interested in having your name solely on the back of the shirts again, yeah, we're looking for $1,500 for sole ownership of that.
And one of the things I did today was on my Facebook, I changed my profile picture to our little Camp Raleigh circle.
Isn't the PTO wanting to be on the back of the shirt now, though, for that 50% donation?
No.
Did I misunderstand that?
Their donation is just to support Camp Raleigh.
Like they'll come and be on the back of the shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I just have a question I want to throw out there. So if we're asking for C&J to sponsor, I know last year that we still had people pay for the shirts, but isn't the idea of C&J sponsoring so that nobody has to pay for any shirts?
No,
is that
the staff shirts.
What's that?
It was covered in staff shirts.
Staff shirts.
I thought it was.
And did you run out of shirts last year?
We ran out of certain sizes.
Yeah.
But not too bad.
Oh,
the parents are like, okay, it's a shirt, like it'll fit them, even if it's a little big. So.
And that, the price for the shirts, I think was all of the shirts, community shirts, regular shirts, and stuff was around $1,500. And then we included a shirt in the registration fee.
Yeah,
and then extra shirts, like if you wanted to buy a second or third shirt,
yeah.
That became the parental responsibility.
Yeah. Well, yeah, if you're going to send your kid every day, you're going to need more than just one shirt. Yeah. So.
Probably. I'll take inventory at home of what I have for shirts.
So, yeah, are we thinking that we're going to go this with the same color and then people can be like, well, I don't really need a new shirt, or are we just going to hand them out? Or
I'm thinking I'd like to keep the campers the same color.
Yeah.
Counselors have to be a different color.
Yeah.
And you can think light blue or something?
Yeah, like a brighter blue. So it's, you can tell that we're connected by a shirt.
Yeah.
Tin.
Then you send that idea to Kristen, because Kristen is the one that deals with the colors and how it goes with the background.
I'm
okay.
How it goes with the background.
Mm-hmm.
I guess how it.
Oh yeah, I think it's blue.
How it screens.
Yep.
So, because she said something about colors last year. I remember that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was tough
and
to do two different colors, right? Or it was more
expensive.
I would
prefer the cameras stay the same color because I still have some shirts.
And that's included in their registration fee, right?
Yep.
So, but I do want counselors to be a different color because some of them are the same size.
Yeah.
We have very tall campers and very tiny counselors.
Especially in our older group.
Yeah. I was also looking at the other people we spoke to last year, and maybe I should just send this out. People who gave us donations and we talked to, and whether or not we should add to the list, just go back to those same people.
And we definitely should go back to the same people, for sure.
And there are four companies I was looking at getting money from through grants and loans now that we have a mission statement.
Mm-hmm.
Eastern Bank, Dick's Sporting Goods, Poland Spring Waters, and Rollinsford Education Fund, which we used last year. So we need to get working on those because a lot of them require a 60-day before your program starts. So did we have a start date for our program?
Yes.
I saw the 25th.
Yeah.
June 25th.
And does it run through August 17th?
Yeah. I think that's 8 weeks through this year.
Yes.
When's the last day of school? Do you know yet?
We do not know yet.
It's probably going to be June 22nd
again. It's
going to
be right up there. Yeah.
Yeah.
And if we go after funds from these companies, do we want to restrict our funding requests just to Camp Raleigh and Team Camp, or do we want to include like basketball or winter rec? Because
let's just do the camp.
Let's just do the camp.
Yes, that's where we're going to have our
budget.
You're
going to need all the revenue you can get.
How much are we having for grant money?
Budget line. We need to talk about the special ed program, too, versus field trips.
Mm-hmm.
Was the special ed program 3 days a week?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Three consecutive days is what they...
Consecutive days.
Mm-hmm.
So it runs into field trips.
So our field trips would only be Monday and Friday, our only option.
Okay.
Although,
or
if
Thursday
pool
set
Friday afternoons, like it has to be Friday afternoons.
Yes, I already reached out to them and said, is there any way that we could change you? And I don't know if just because we're low man on the totem pole that we got last dibs, but he said right now that Fridays is still the best day for us as far as numbers go. So yeah, unfortunately we're locked into that one.
So I was going to say the special ed program is done by noon. So if the pool was able to move, we wouldn't be locked into Mondays and Fridays.
Mm.
So
I can reach out again and just say, hey, can we possibly move in this one day? Because
well,
then we could do what are you thinking that we could do the full day
so
field trip on Friday?
Yeah,
and then move the swim day to any day we wanted to.
Yeah. So like a lake or whatever on Friday. And then.
Yeah.
Now, my understanding was is that as long as they had 3 consecutive days for special ed, they could do it in
right.
Like 3 days. So is it planned for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday?
I think she was going to be flexible depending on what we came up with.
Yeah.
But the thought about that, Celia,
Wednesday.
I think, was even if they did Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, that do we really want to go on field trips Thursday or Friday?
Yeah.
Right.
It's exhausting for the kids.
Yeah.
Exhausting for them.
I think Monday and Friday, especially
especially after being home all weekend, looking forward to a field trip is good. Like, it's a good space, you know, because you're going somewhere at both ends of the week, you know.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
I think, and then during the week, like, you have other things, like walking to the library, mm-hmm. and I think that's really good when you buy.
And it coordinates with the teen camp going off campus Monday and Fridays. But what pops into my head is, like, those people that take long weekends during the summer.
Right.
And they're gone Monday through a Friday, and then, or Friday through Monday.
It's personal responsibility.
Yeah.
I mean, your kids are going to miss out something sometimes because you're making up decisions. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not going to rearrange my summer to fit into the camp.
I don't know. I totally understand what you're saying. But,
my question with the school was, and I don't know if we, you know, I know that was, we couldn't talk about, I know one of my kids was in the program, and he actually won't be in the program this summer. So when we, you know, I did have that chat with Kate about how many kids, or what I did was send out a list of all the kids who signed up for a camp, and I don't, do you know how many kids overlapped and how many you did? There weren't a ton.
It was 10 and under, for sure. Like, it wasn't a fairly large percentage.
So, you know.
But we did lose them on field trips and stuff.
What do you mean?
So only 10 kids that are doing the special ed, that would be affected by a Tuesday field trip.
And if two of them have an 8 or 8:30 slot, then they don't miss the field trip at all.
Right.
So.
It's about enough. We switch everything all around.
I'm not
for 10 kids.
I'm not understanding. You're saying that maybe I'm just coming in late here, but
there are certain kids that go to summer school, and summer school is 3 days in a row.
The special education program.
Right.
And so last year we did field trips on Tuesday.
Okay.
So those kids
missed the field trip or missed summer school.
Oh, they're in both programs.
Yes.
I get it.
Oh, but what I'm saying is that there was 10 or less that had that overlap.
Okay.
So,
and most parents picked the bus and the field trip.
I did.
Okay. And I apologize. I didn't realize that. I was like,
we're going on a field trip.
Sorry.
So if field trips are Monday and Fridays, are you going on a field trip the first week?
Probably not.
No.
I can't imagine.
I would not go on
the
field
especially
trip.
Especially
on the first day. No.
But wait, also. Special ed does not start until
after 4th of July, probably.
Yes. So we actually have, we might have the first 2 weeks we could do it. Right. We could stick with the Tuesday and then move it. So let's do you want to take
that,
Lee? Find out when special ed program starts and when it ends too. Because it might end.
We might get
first week of August, so
mm-hmm.
so maybe we only have 4 weeks of Monday Friday trips.
August 17th.
Thank you. Sorry,
the end date.
Thank you.
Are you taking
Brittany's
going to
ask the question.
Talking about field trips, have we paid for our park pass yet, or is that coming later on this summer?
I have not done anything with the park pass yet.
Okay.
The question might be is how many of those do we want to do? And
well, one PO for two, 10 pass. One PO for two, 10 plus passes.
One PO for that? Are we still going to continue to do that with Camp Raleigh, or is that a discussion?
Ness and I talked about it. We took a poll kind of between counselors and whatever, and White Lake, Wentworth, and Tuckway kids loved those because they had big playgrounds and snack shacks to go to.
Oh, that's funny. So which three? Say that again.
White Lake, Wentworth, and
should have talked about this.
Like,
and how was the trip to White?
always really quiet, but the ride there is ridiculous because they're so excited. They're just so loud. But they handle it okay. I think they wish they had more time there because it is so far away. But that's something that we can plan for, like having it organized enough so when they do get there, they can literally just get off the bus and go. Instead of, no, wait, stay here, we need to do this and this and this.
Yeah. Jody, how much did you say the cost was? I'm sorry. Did you say the cost? You were talking about 10 packs? Was it 10 packs?
No, it's a 10 pass, and we need two of them this year. And I looked it up earlier.
Sorry, I actually might have that.
Are we handing that off to Brittany to do this year? Because last year, we put it
Are you guys going to do that? And I just call and pick them up? Is that what you mean?
What?
Do we get the pass?
Well, we have to buy
them. I have two more bus passes. Would you like them for 2017?
So what you're saying is,
those are just the ones that they preferred the most. We only send less kids for those ones. We were trying to think of other low-cost things like the lakes, other state park kind of things. I want to take them hiking. I think that they would love that. And those are included in the parks too, so stuff like that. I need to do a little bit more research on them and find the right trails.
Last year we got 10 park passes to get saved, and there was concern on the committee, and I don't know if it still exists, so this is a question for the committee members, whether or not the ocean is an option, because last year it wasn't an option with parents.
I would say no.
I would say absolutely no.
And there's just too many variables there. I would be concerned.
Did you go to
El
Coya last year?
No, we tried putting them in one of the last minute ones, but they were booked.
Am I the only parent that sent my kids with a life jacket?
No, a couple
people. Okay.
A couple people did.
I didn't see any other life jackets. Yeah.
His age, I think you were the only one, but a lot of the 3 and unders had them because of their weight, they needed them in the pool.
Oh, okay.
What about, Wall of Sands is on here. I know that we just talked about the beach for a second, but they have a way to put there. Just throwing it out there.
Have suggestions you want to, besides this meeting, do you want to submit it in like a Google Doc instead of?
Yeah, or email it to Camp Raleigh directors.
Okay.
I can pull up last year's surveys too because we had some good suggestions from there, about activities in general.
Yeah.
So the select board made a comment last year, and I don't know if Jody remembers it, but they would like the Camp Raleigh email to go through the town.
The camp directors.
Yeah, did you know?
Yeah, Suzanne, you guys weren't supposed to set that up. She was upset with that.
And no, but Andy made it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We heard about it at a board meeting after Andy made it.
Yeah.
So, we need to get you a...
Because it's not...
Right,
because
it's...
A secure, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Well, what about, so remember at the end of the year we sent people to the golfing place. Can never remember what that's called. Hilltop Fun Center.
Yes.
Now we don't
that, you know, are all inclusive here. We don't have, you know,
the big trips like that.
Wiggle room in there for a $20 expense per kid.
Mm-hmm.
How do we?
Well, that $800 beyond that second check.
That's true.
Yes. And then if we get any of these grants, then I might go after.
Should we?
Plus, you have $400 contingency because we don't know what the school is going to be remodeling in the summer yet. Do we? Do they know yet?
I have no clue.
One of my questions was as far as Kate, who wants to be the Kate connection?
Brittany.
Do you want to be the Kate connection?
Yeah,
because I think that was one of my questions. So,
yes.
I wonder, would she come in the category of the work study question?
She wouldn't, because she's not a recreation management major. I know, it's a bummer.
Yeah, it's okay, though.
Yeah.
If we have good staff.
Yeah.
Well, is it just recreation management that can apply for the work study, or is it any student that has leftover work study money?
That I don't know. It's a good question. Kathy?
Yeah, I'll answer that. I'll tackle it.
Kathy's our work study coordinator.
Oh, I don't know.
So, Brittany, can you write down to ask Kate about any construction or anything going on in the summer? And I think Jody had heard about air conditioning, right? The possibility of air conditioning?
No, I'm over there pressing it.
No? That would be awesome.
Yeah. I thought that was discussed at a school board meeting.
Honestly, I've not gone to one.
There was no discussion about air conditioning last school board meeting. They talked about doing the annex roof, and that was pretty much the old. That's all that like a big expense that I remember them talking about. That was the kindergarten annex roof.
So
that's $10.
So in March we're voting on all the a bunch of the repair work that they're going
to
do. Yeah, we talked about the annex roof, and
that's
not true because in March, there was no mention of paving, and all of a sudden we got paving.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So they took the leftover money and paved.
Yeah.
So we don't know until the last minute.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
So it's
I'll find out what's available to us this year in terms of rooms and.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hopefully they're not remodeling them.
They are doing something electrical.
Yeah.
Do you remember that? They said something about electric that day.
We'll find out more.
Was
it's all on the school ballot. What does they spend money on?
Was there any chit chat about the scoreboard? Because we had our first basketball meeting on the first basketball game on Friday, and the scoreboard doesn't work apparently. And if you go to the side, it looks like the wire to the scoreboard was just cut.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if that was because of what the work. Didn't they do something in the gym this past
They did a lot of electrical stuff.
Yeah.
And they were putting in phase three, whatever.
Right, so you think they just cut that cord?
They might have.
We have a little.
Yeah, we're playing on Tuesday.
I know.
I saw that. girls versus boys.
Thank you.
So
so on our teen camp right now, I look at that our schedule only has 4 state park. Do we just want to go ahead and purchase 10? I don't know what the difference. There are a 5, there's a 5 pass.
So do you want a 10 and a 5?
We would save money that way.
Okay.
Want to do that?
Yeah.
I'll do a 10 and a 5.
So 5 for you guys and 10 for us?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wonder if there's a, and we only get one $10 fee per application.
So 10.
So that's
okay. $10.
All right, that'll save us some money. $100. Woo!
There you go.
So I'll take care of this.
Okay.
And this is good. I did, last year I only did it March 3rd. So.
There you go.
You're doing
schedule.
Woohoo!
Yeah, just let me know how much it is.
Okay.
So Kelly and I were just talking about that, you know how Lester was, between Lester and Caroline, and money was everywhere. So her and I disagreed that everything was going to filter through me. So with the new registration system, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be so much easier.
The
everything outside of that
is going directly to work.
Good. Anything outside of that, like any
very little
sponsorships or fundraising or any other stuff?
So we just make sure that all goes.
All the box stuff, like popsicles and whatnot.
Yeah, we'll figure out how to.
Okay.
If there's an extra cost, like you want to send your kid to the movies, it's going to be $20 or whatever. Would they be able to pay through the website instead of the people?
That would have to be set up ahead of time. I can't answer that yet because I haven't even had my onboarding webinar with the software people yet.
Right.
Just bought it last week.
I know that was Monday. Did that get changed?
It did get changed to Tuesday because apparently they have President's Day off.
Tuesday?
So it's Tuesday at... Tuesday 20th at noon.
That's just gonna go.
I'm gonna send you an email.
Okay. Oh, cool. I'm available.
Question: are we gonna keep pizza dates or not? That was my
question.
I like Brittany's opinion on that.
The last week of camp, or the week before last week of camp, when I was there all day every day when he was doing stuff, it was actually easier. Jess and I had it figured out, and that week pizza was super easy. It was on time and everything. I just don't know cost efficiently if it even benefited us. Like, I don't know how much we actually made from it.
Yeah, we thought we'd have it delivered this year no matter what.
Yeah. Well,
it can decide to do it.
Right. Because there is a pizza place in Dover that could deliver here. And they give us a flat school rate of, or camp rate, of $8 a pizza. And their pizza is bigger, and so they can cut it into 12 slices.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know financially if that's a nightmare or not. Do you pay ahead of time for that?
I don't want my son eating pizza every week. I don't want there's an option. Because we eat pretty healthy. So, not that pizza's not a healthy thing, but for our family, we don't eat pizza every week. So I don't want to meet pizza every week, but maybe every other week as an option. Maybe if it's easier.
And if it's every other week, we might still send him
in full lunch anyway. Yeah.
And I do. I'm not saying.
I did that at the time just because I forgot anyway.
Yeah.
And then you don't have parents from money. Yeah. Or
so you're thinking every other week. I think that would be a good idea because every week is.
Then it's like a benefit too. Ooh, this
right.
Where should we go?
Then you're going to have to remind.
Oh, yeah.
Ice cream week.
You?
Let's talk about the healthy snack.
I will text you.
Ice cream sundae week.
They software
will be 50 pounds.
I'm excited for the software.
Yes. And are we going to keep the pricing the same? Oh, I guess we don't know. Was it beneficial to us or not?
Let's just table that and we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
Maybe next meeting.
Yeah. I'm about fried. Does anybody want to add anything else?
Anybody want to throw anything at me while I have my computer open?
Did you say anything about it?
I'm
going
to email her.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to be hated.
Do you know how many extra hours you're
going to
need outside of the camp? I mean, so training, actually.
Oh,
yeah.
If
we get all the same stuff back,
we
don't have a lot of training or senior certifications to do.
Yes.
So
if you want them trained in both.
What was it, 4 hours? Did you do both?
Oh, that's right.
So if you want camp counselors trained in both, we do have to do CPR and first aid because only half of us did one and half of us did the other, so we would have to switch.
Oh, yes. And then that would go through the school as well because the fire will do it.
Okay.
So
I need to figure out what that is.
But we have money in the budget for that because I budgeted for that this year.
And then
but that's good if we have all extra. I personally, at this point, my 2 cents on that. When I interviewed all these guys last year, they all said to me up front, should I find a class for that? And at the time, I said no, because we had that thought that we weren't going to need to do that. I think, honestly, if we have any new staff that needs both, I think we should look right at our new person and say, you need to find a class on your own.
Are we reimbursing them?
She still teaches the CPR class at the hospital.
Or we give them the day, because if we're going to have our other staff members do that one day, right, where they have one, I think we need to ask them to go find the other class.
If they need both, yeah.
And I think we need to have them pay for it themselves, just because it's a private job.
Well, even with Liberty Mutual, they pay for it.
Yeah, I think you should give them at least some money towards it. Mm-hmm.
I think too.
They're gaining a scale, but it's
$100.
Yeah.
We only budgeted $50.
Right. So it depends. So it's depending on the staff, if we have any new staff.
So maybe we could get this schedule from
the
staff.
Yeah. Because I've been hired for jobs before that have looked at me and said, "Are you CPR certified?" And I'm like, no. You need to do that before you start this position.
Yeah.
Do you want this position? I don't know. I mean, most everybody last year, before we offered it to people, were willing to go and get it and pay for it and have it done. So, I don't know.
So can I just touch on something?
Sure.
Are you done talking?
Yeah, that was like 2 cents.
Membership. I got an email from Suzanne and an email from Jody. The town clerk wanted to know our committee membership for the town book, and we did, anybody besides what's on the Google Drive, does it need to be updated for March? Any membership?
No. The book is for who is an existing member.
Yeah.
So they can just pull it from the Google Drive.
So yeah.
We just updated the Google Drive 3 weeks ago.
Right.
Yeah. So what goes in the book is who was current this year.
And I dropped that off already.
Come March, it's whoever gets appointed after town meeting.
But do we have to tell the select board anybody new to be appointed? Or are we going to put off that until the next one? Or next week?
Yeah, I don't know. So March 17th, whatever my last day is.
Was that out loud? Oops.
No, I heard
sorry.
That.
Because yes, March 17th. You've already expressed to the select board that you would like to stay on the rec committee.
I can change my mind.
Okay. But I don't know, do we want to add Liberty to the
She's an alternate already.
Oh, well, she's not on the list as an alternate.
She was on the list.
She is.
Isn't she? I'll go back to, I can't go back to the Google Drive on my phone.
I have a staffing question to put for all of us. We have heard back from several. Are we putting any type of like kind of time frame
yes.
on this? So you did have time frame on
letter
that?
States. What did my letter say to
you? Exactly.
I did give them a deadline.
Okay. Because, yeah, if we do need to hire more staff, we need to...
Yeah, they had to tell me in March.
March 1st.
Okay.
That's what
are you in contact email-wise with...
After she told me that she sent everybody an email, I texted everybody telling them to check her emails.
Yeah.
Luke answered me, and I know a couple have answered, just, like, said things in... the group Snapchat that they have.
Oh,
I deleted
so
Snapchat,
cute.
So I took myself out of the group chat, I will remind them.
Yeah. So yeah, maybe give a reminder like we need to know.
Yeah, by March 1st.
Okay, March 1st. And then that way, because if we need to advertise again or...
I sent it out once and then I sent it out again that she was the director.
Yep.
Awesome.
So they would know who their boss would be. Yep. Awesome. Jody, you're on top of things. I'm so impressed. On that note of being so impressed,
motion to adjourn.
Oh, what's next meeting?
Oh.
March 11th,
you think? I'm going to say no. Town meeting.
Okay.
Unless you want to spend 3 days together. I know. We have such a good time.
How about the 4th?
Yeah, the 4th is good. 4th works for me.
then actually, so we should know at that point. We should hear from everybody should have responded, and then that way we can kind of go forward with.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, with staffing, and if we need any.
It's like 7 o'clock again.
Yeah. Okay. 4th at 7.
So we have
18.
Okay.
Motion to adjourn.